கோயம்புத்தூர் சேலம் கோயம்புத்தூர் ரயில் எண் 66 602 66 603 ஆகிய ரயில்கள் இயக்கப்பட்டது. பல ஆயிரக்கணக்கான தொழிலாளர்கள் வசதிக்காக மீண்டும் இடையில் நிறுத்தப்பட்ட அந்த ரயில்களை தொடர்ந்து இயக்கிட வேண்டுகிறேன். மேலும் பழைய இசா திட்டத்தை நடைமுறைப்படுத்த வேண்டுகிறேன். கொரோனா தொழிலுக்கு முன்புவரை நடைமுறையில் இருந்த பயணிகளுக்கு சீசன் டிக்கெட் பெறும் வசதியை மீண்டும் நடைமுறைப்படுத்தி பயணிகளுக்கு சீசன் டிக்கெட் வழங்கிட வேண்டுகிறேன். ஈரோடு வழியாக செல்லும் அனைத்து ரயில்களில் துரித ரயில்களிலும் முன்பதிவு டிக்கெட் பெற முடியாத நிலை உருவாகியிருக்கிறது. அதை தீர்க்கிற வகையில் அனைத்து ரயில்களிலும் முன்பதிவு இல்லா.
The recent monsoons have wreaked havoc in South Indian states, sir. Andhra, Kerala, parts of Kerala, Pondicherry and Tamil Nadu were badly affected. And especially in Tamil Nadu, sir, it is recorded the third highest amount of rains ever in the history over the last 200 years, sir. So it has caused a lot of inundation, and more than 150,000 acres of farmlands have been destroyed. So I request the government to see, the Honorable Chief Minister has written to the government seeking relief, where about 2,500 crores of interim relief has been requested, sir. I request you to provide that. And also, during this weather conditions, there is an app called Mausam, sir. So when flying from Delhi and to and from Delhi, I was told Mausam is weather. So Mausam kharab hai, sir, because the app is also very bad, because that app does not give adequate detail about forecasting of rains, which will be very useful for the common people, and it is available only in English and Hindi, sir. I request that the app should be made available in all region languages so that every can benefit.
Dayanidhi Maran ji, aapko mananiya sadasya mein सवाल पूछने, नहीं सवाल पूछने की इजाजत दे रहा हूं, लेकिन आइंदा बेटे बेटे टिप्पणी मत करना.
यू कैन ट्रस्ट मी सर. सर, आई एम हैप्पी टू सी द आंसर गिवन बाय द मिनिस्टर सर. द मिनिस्टर हैज टेकन द मिनिस्ट्री हैज टेकन अ नाइस एटीट्यूड ऑफ कंसीडरिंग चिल्ड्रन फॉर यूजिंग ड्रग्स एज नॉट कल्प्रिट्स बट एज विक्टिम्स. सो सिंस द होम मिनिस्टर इज हियर, आई कांट मिस द अपॉर्चुनिटी. बट द सेम एनसीबी व्हिच कम्स अंडर द होम मिनिस्ट्री लुक्स द अदर वे अराउंड सर. They consider, they want to make a sensation of small incident, even if the person is drug used or not, of making a child get arrested, getting publicity. So this is sending a wrong message. And I also want to like to know, sir, can you give a state-wise, because you did a survey, the survey should be complete if you give a state-wise number. And I'm, as I have said, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh are considered to be the top of drug using states, sir. This will be useful for us economically and also to realize how
to go माननीय मंत्री जी इनको, ठीक है, अनुभव मोती भेज देना इनको, खड़े होकर बोल दो ना, भेज दूंगा मैं.
माननीय सभापति महोदय, जो विस्तृत जानकारी माननीय सदस्य के द्वारा मांगी गई है, मैं उनको लिखित रूप से उपलब्ध करा दी.
श्री अनुभव मोती जी, डीएम कदीर आनंद जी.
थैंक यू ऑनरेबल स्पीकर सर. Ambur and Vaniyambadi are two important commercial towns in my Vellur Lok Sabha constituency. Both contribute substantially to the foreign exchange and exchequer. Construction of a rail overbridge at Vaniyambadi and Reddithoppu in Ambur are pending for several years. It is LC533. These two railway overbridge are very important for the passengers of commuters of all walks of life, including office goers, school and college students. At Reddithoppu, the existing underpass is awfully inadequate for large number of commuters who have no other way to cross from both the sides. During rainy time, the underpass is full of water and sewage water. This is the plight of people of Ambur, which can be solved only by construction of a railway overbridge at a Reddithoppu area in Ambur. This will benefit the entire area. This I have raised many times in this August house, but still the project is pending and it has not been taken up. Secondly, sir, before corona there were three trains, Kaveri Express, Erkad Express and Samraj Express, which were stopped at Ambur station, but after corona it has not been stopped. So I request to the honorable speaker to stop the station. And again, another town is Vaniyambadi, where there is another bridge which is required, LC81. Nearly 120 trains cross this LC81, and people cannot commute from this way to other, and they are all
Gopal
standard.
Ji Thakur.
Sir, 1 minute, sir. I am concluding, sir. So I definitely need a railway overbridge. This project was commenced in the previous years, but I don't know for what reason the project was stopped again. and now I request to the speaker to expedite this process and construct a overbridge at Vanimbadi. Thank you, sir.
Gopal Ji Thakur, Ravindranath.
Thank you, Speaker, sir. Sir, in Tamil Nadu, grape is cultivated in an area of 2,800 hectares, out of which 2,184 hectares of land are in my Theni parliamentary constituency. So the district of Theni accounts for major share of grape production in Tamil Nadu. To extend the area of cultivation of commercial grape varieties and to encourage involvement of farmers in grape cultivation with application of scientific methods as well as to increase research and development programs. So I hence request the government through you, sir, to take appropriate action to include the grapes research station Anamalayanpatti in my Theni Parliament constituency as one of the regular center under Indian Council for Agricultural Research, All India Coordinated Research Project on Fruits Program with adequate staff, funds and infrastructure. Thank you, sir.
Sri Amar Singh Ji. Honorable Chairperson,
thank you for the opportunity. I raise here to register my strong disappointment over the lackluster performance of the National Highway Authority of India in my constituency. There is a road formed, widening the road of 43 kilometers from Madhavaram to Thada. And this project has been going on for the last 5 to 6 years. Even now, it is not sure when they will complete this project. The government has been, the department, that is National Highway Authority of India, is giving the contractor extended opportunities. And the additional payments cost run is also taking place. And the project is of about 300 crores. And they are taking more years. I urge upon the government through you to take immediate steps to see that this project is completed, as it is a nuisance to the people Kachadiyam over there. Thank you.
Narayan Bhai Kachadiyam.
Sir, Honorable Chairperson, sir. Sir, I would like to take this opportunity to draw the attention of the government through you, sir. In the Thinjapalli Panchayat near Ullatti village in Krishnagiri district, there is a narrow railway underpass on the Salem-Hosur sector. People from Thinjapalli Panchayat and Panchapalli Panchayat use this underpass for commuting to and fro from the schools, colleges, hospitals and to the workplace. The farmers, for their daily movement to their farmland and mobility of their agricultural produce, are finding it difficult to cross this particular place because of the narrow passage, and therefore they have to take their detour of 20 kilometers to cross over to the other side.
Thank you.
Hence, I kindly request you, sir, to build a wider railway underpass, underbridge, to have an easy passage for the daily commuters.
Thank you.
Sir, I rise here to request regarding the Madurai Airport, sir. There is a discrimination towards Madurai Airport and in the airport which came into existence in 1956, and it got the new terminal in 2010 in the UPA government, but still wait for a international status. We are not against any of the airport which is like Gorakhpur or Tirupati airports. They're all upgraded towards international airport, but Madurai Airport, why this discrimination continues? We are waiting for the bilateral agreement with the Gulf countries in Malaysia, Singapore and others, and there are total South India, South Tamil Nadu is connected through Madurai Airport. I would like to request the Honorable Civil Aviation Minister to grant international status to the Madurai Airport as early as possible.
Thank you, sir.
அவைத்தலைவர் அவர்களே, நான் சார்ந்துள்ள தென்காசி தொகுதி முழுவதும் விவசாயம் சார்ந்த தொகுதி. இந்த பகுதி விவசாயிகளின் வாழ்வாதாரத்தை பாதுகாப்பதற்கும் மேம்படுத்துவதற்கும் ஒன்றிய அரசாங்கத்தினுடைய உணவு பூங்கா திட்டத்தை இப்பகுதியில் செயல்படுத்துவதுடன், நீண்ட காலமாக கேரளா அரசாங்கத்துடன் தீர்க்கப்படாமல் இருக்கும் செண்பகவல்லி அணை பிரச்சனையை தீர்த்து வைத்து இந்த பகுதியில் பல ஆயிரம் ஏக்கர் நிலங்கள் பாசன வசதி பெறுவதற்கு வழிவகை செய்ய வேண்டும் எனவும், 80% விவசாய நிலங்கள் மேற்கு தொடர்ச்சி மலை அடிவாரத்தில் உள்ளது, இந்த பகுதியில் உள்ள விவசாய நிலங்கள் ஆண்டு முழுவதும் வனவிலங்குகளால் பாதிப்பிற்கு உள்ளாகின்றன, குறிப்பாக செங்கோட்டை பகுதிகளில் யானைகளால் விவசாயிகள் தொடர்ந்து பாதிப்புக்கு உள்ளாகிறார்கள், அதை தடுப்பதற்கு நிரந்தர நடவடிக்கை எடுக்க வேண்டும் எனவும், ஒன்றிய அரசாங்கத்தால் தற்பொழுது அறிவிக்கப்பட்டுள்ள நான்கு வழிச்சாலை திட்டத்தில் இந்த பகுதி விவசாயிகளின் கோரிக்கைகளை முழுவதுமாக ஏற்க வேண்டும் எனவும் தங்கள் மூலமாக ஒன்றிய அரசாங்கத்தை கேட்டுக்கொள்கிறேன். நன்றி, வணக்கம்.
Sir, the river Ganga, the holy river of India, travels at 2,500 kilometers and ends at the 1/4 of Indian lands. Similarly, the river Kaveri is the source of the livelihood of the 4 states, including Tamil Nadu. 16 districts, the people of Tamil Nadu use the Kaveri river water for drinking and agriculture irrigation purpose. The river Ganga and the Kaveri have the power of purifying themselves naturally, although the river Ganga and the Kaveri have been polluted for the various reasons. From time to time, the government has made the efforts to prevent.
Yes. Sir,
in 2014, the central government launched the Namami Ganga project to clean up the Ganga River. This project was implemented at an estimate of cost 20,000 crores. Sir, it cost the union government implement the project to clean up the river Kaveri, the holy river of the South India, and to allocate the necessary funds for it is a coming financial year. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. The last speaker.